Hey guys, Corey here. Got a carpet stretching job here that's got more to do with customer service than it does carpet stretching. As soon as I show you the carpet, you'll understand. So let me show you what I'm gonna do and what all we decided not to do. Basically because we want the client to be happy and get them what they need, rather get them basically what they want. Basically if you have plan A, which is the right way to do it, plan B and C that will also make them happy, we're with like plan C. So let me show you. All right, let me show you all the factors here. Carpet's been here since 99, so technically it would need to be stretched two different ways. So it's extremely loose here, in here. You got tile on both sides. We've got cutouts here, and we've got wrinkling that's up the wall here. So it is extremely loose. So this room would need to be stretched probably a little bit in both directions because we couldn't have it come off that wall. And then you would probably almost need to go the other direction with the carpet too. So after talking for about 20 minutes, it turns out that this over here is the most important thing. So for a fraction of what they were gonna spend and us have to reschedule, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna fix that and we're gonna clean. So you never know what you're gonna get when you get out in the field. You have to be able to talk to your client, interview them, and decide what it's gonna take to make them happy. It's not about doing the job the way, you know, somebody would say, oh, well, you need, somebody watching the video saying, oh, you need to stretch it, you know, the correct way. Well, that's the way you start, is the correct way. But if the correct way is not always possible that day, good enough will sometimes do. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the door open, I'm gonna stretch that together, and it'll be tight enough that basically I can probably just tuck that in and cut it off and be good, and then move straight on with the cleaning. And there's other rooms that need to be stretched too, but the furniture just won't allow it. Got the big heavy bed here, we got wrinkling in here, so several rooms have it. But anyway, that's what we're gonna do here today. And I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and I'll vlog along, and then before long we'll be cleaning in a different video. So let me cut the carpet and we'll get to moving. All right, upon closer inspection, it looks like there's a little, this is different. I'm fixing a piece here where for some reason they have a strip in here that I don't know what, something goofed up during installation or something. So basically, a little piece over here is doing this right here. So I'm gonna fix that, and then I'm going to open it up, not here, but basically make my own little seam right here. So I'm responsible for both cuts rather than using somebody else's. So I've gotta fix a little bit before I make my first cut. I don't know that I remember seeing anything like this in the past. Well, at least not to this degree. All the extra trouble they went to patch this piece in here during install, how they managed to not get any of that glued down, or maybe it just turned loose since 99. I guess this part just turned loose. So got a long time on this carpet here, so we're gonna see what we can bring this back to Jesus after all these years. All right, I'm just bringing this guy to a close here. It's difficult when you're over concrete. If you're upstairs over a wooden subfloor, you can nail it all exactly where you need it. That wasn't the case here. Over here, I had to basically pull it open and put hot glue under it and mash it back together. And when I did, the hot glue got between my fingers. So luckily I got to the bucket, and that's where I then keeping them here, peeled hot glue off while I was underwater. So that is definitely going to leave a mark. If I only had some lidocaine gel with me, that would make the rest of this job go so much nicer. But if it wasn't for this bucket, I don't know, I probably wouldn't have saved the skin. Tell her, I'm gonna try to blister on the thumb. I'm gonna say I got between the fingers, I mashed it, and got between the two, not stuck together. So, ouch. Almost done here. All right, got it all closed up here. That was difficult and just a little bit painful. Considering the age, how much trouble I had over here, turned out really well. I would love to get a little more heat on that, but I'm afraid if I tried to squeeze it together and heat it, I may wind up doing some more or coming apart on me. So I don't want to leave well enough alone. And then here, got this guy all put into place, and that's what I cut off after I got it all tucked in and then trimmed it and tucked again. All right, that has more to do with reading the customer than it does actual carpet work. Anybody can come in and pull it off, but trying to extract that information out of your customer when they don't know enough about carpet work to tell you exactly what they want, you've got to try to present two or three different options and find out what's going to work out best for them. And they have a house showing later today, so I'm glad that I was able to get all this fixed before the house gets shown today. Now I've got to hurry up and clean the carpet, so it'll only be a little bit wet by the time the people get here and look at the house. Thanks for watching, and God bless. See you on the next video.